Alright guys, let's make games. What we're going to do now is a quick video just to show you how to set up SDL2 on Windows using Visual Studio 2017 Community. This is for the Windows users that will be following the roguelike adventure series. So, first thing you want to do is navigate to libsdl.org, take to this homepage, and we need to download the current stable version. So if we click here, then we need to scroll down to the development libraries, and we want SDL2 development VC zip. We're just going to quickly download that. We're just going to save it. Alright, that's done. We're going to unzip it. Okay, we're just going to extract all, and we're going to extract it. Just make sure for SDL and extract. Now, what we're going to want to do here is copy this somewhere on the computer, because we're going to constantly reference this with different projects from one place rather than having one set of files in every single project. Just going to rename this to SDL2. I'm going to copy that and go to my C drive, and I've got a folder called dev. You can have it whatever you want it called, it doesn't really matter, as long as you know where it is. And we're going to paste that into there. So now we've done that, we'll get into Visual Studio. So loading up Visual Studio 2017. Right, we have a few steps here. So first thing we want to do is set up a new empty project. So file, new, project. What we're going to do, we're going to pick a Visual C++ empty project here. And we're just going to call this first SDL window. So create the project for us. Then we just need to change a few settings, make sure Visual Studio knows where all our SDL files are. So let's do that. First thing I'm going to do is create a C++ file so Visual Studio knows what sort of project this is. So in the Solution Explorer, we're going to right click, and we're going to click go to add, and we're going to add a new item. Now we're going to call this main.cpp, and we're going to add that file. Next thing we need to do is link the files to the project. So we're going to right click this, go to properties. This is where we can change all the settings for our project. So first thing we need to do is go to C++ general, and this is where we can include the SDL header files. So in the down arrow, edit, and create a new line, then three dots for browse, and this is where we go to dev. I'm going to go to the SDL2 file, include, and select that folder and click OK. Then we need to go to the linker, so we need to know where the library is, to general, then to additional library directories. In this case, we're going to go again, new, browse, go to SDL2, and this library, and we're going to pick x64 for 64-bit. And when you click OK, click OK. Next thing is the input, and here on additional dependencies, when you click the down arrow, go to edit, we need to add sdl2.lib and sdl2main.lib and click OK. Now once that's done, we can go to system, and for subsystem here we're going to change that to subsystem console, and we're going to click apply and OK. Now, one more thing before we can start writing code is to copy the SDL2 DLL to our project folder. So if we go to our file explorer, go to where our project is, so under our dev, then oral SDL, so where our dev folder is, SDL2, now under lib, x64 is the one we picked, is SDL2.dll, we're going to copy that, And we're going to paste that into our first SDL window project in the same folder as our main CPP. And we're going to paste that there. Now we can start writing some code. So now we can start writing our code to get a window. First thing to do is include the SDL header. So we're going to include SDL.h. We need to create our main function. We need an int amount of arguments and the argument variables. So return 0. Right, with our main function now, we can create the window. So initialize the SDL subsystems. I'm just going to SDL init everything, create an SDL window to render to, create window, this takes a title, a position on screen, SDL window centered. That's same again, so we're going to copy that. And its size, so in this case I'm just going to go 600 by 400 and SDL window shown. We'll do a more in-depth video later on, as this is part of a series. This is to make sure everyone's up and running with SDL before we start making a game. So we need a renderer. Equals SDL. Create renderer. When I can spell. This takes a window, which we created earlier, index and flags 0. What we can do is make sure that we can see it. We're going to set the SDL render draw color. So set render draw color. This takes the renderer. And a color. We'll pick green, so 0, 255, 0, and then the alpha channel being this. For a bit more information about what all these are, if you watch the other video in the link for the Mac version, it's more explained. How do we set the render draw color? We need to clear the screen. So render clear. And it needs the renderer, so it knows which it's clearing. That will draw the screen green for us. Then we need to SDL render present. And present the renderer to the screen. Just to get a bit of a delay so we can see this on the screen, we can hit delay. And we'll have 3 seconds. And that's a window. So if I press build, we should have a green window in the middle of the screen. Visual Studio is just loading some external symbols. Should start shortly. And there's our green window. 3 seconds, quit. And that's how you set up an SDL2 window on Windows using Visual Studio 2017. The next video, we will actually start making the game. there'll be a bit of an introduction about what you actually need to actually start making a game, and it will be the game class.